Hi everybody, it's Bruce here with Traveling with Bruce. Thank you for joining me today on my channel. I have some news for you today. Three different stories, two regarding cruise stories and one regarding an airline, and that is an unbelievable story indeed. Thank you, all of you out there who are following me and subscribing to Traveling with Bruce. Love that. Love your thumbs ups and your comments. Keep them coming. Let me know what you think. Also, thanks for following me on my Facebook group page, picking up some items on my RedBubble store, and checking me out on Instagram. Love that too. And one last note, thank you for all of you out there who are becoming sponsor members of Traveling with Bruce, joining up. The links are down below. You get to join me Monday night, 7 o'clock, for a sponsor member hangout show. We talk about anything you want. And then we do the big show at 8 o'clock Monday night. All right. The first story on the agenda has to do with an announcement that came out this morning from Norwegian Cruise Lines. Norwegian was the first of the major cruise lines to officially announce that they will now not sail anywhere with any paying passengers until November the 1st. They have extended their shutdown past through September into October. If they do start November 1, it will be with very limited service. And don't be surprised if in the next few days everybody else follows suit, even though the CDC has a no sail date that goes until September 30th. The CLIA, the Cruise Line International Association, they have a no sail date for all their members until September the 15th. Now we have Norwegian on its own automatically and already admitting, folks, we're not cruising earliest November 1. And I got to tell you, folks, with the COVID numbers being released daily now out of key states like Florida, Texas, California, and other states, it's bad news, because if Florida and Texas and California have very high cases and rising case numbers, this is bad news for the cruise business, because those are the three major states with the most cruise departures. New York is kind of number four, Washington is number five, but Florida, it's all about Florida. If Florida is going to continue on here with 9, 10, 11,000 cases of the virus every day, and the CDC is guesstimating that only maybe one-tenth of the cases are actually being discovered because of limited testing numbers, we could be talking about 100,000 cases a day showing up in Florida that we don't know about, because the people who have the disease, they don't know they have it. And so it doesn't look good for cruising, and I know the folks at Norwegian are already admitting it. All right, other news out of Seattle. Seattle this year really took it on the chin. Obviously, with Canada shutting down access to its ports back in April of this year, all the way through basically for the rest of this year and into the spring of next year, there were not going to be any cruises out of Seattle to Alaska all summer long. And we now have to wait for the government of Canada to tell us whether they're going to extend this lockdown past next spring. In any event, Seattle was really planning on major expansions. So they were really hopeful that they would be able to add a brand new cruise terminal, I think terminal number 48, if I recall, $300+ million project. They were looking for industry partners to build it out. Rumor was that of the big cruise lines, Carnival, Royal Caribbean, Norwegian, they were all interested in being partners with the city of Seattle to get, you know, premium access to the new port. All of that has been shelved. The entire discussion and the entire ability for Seattle to try to get a partner has been thrown out the window, because no cruise line has any spare cash right now to expand anything. So Seattle has killed the project for now. They've shelved it, and we'll wait maybe a year or two before we see anything from that, which is unfortunate. Other news. You want some good news? Here's some good news, folks. Number one, the kind of good news I would like to get is when, if I was working for an employer and my boss said to me, yeah, listen, Bruce, I need you to fly from Los Angeles to Dubai do some business in Dubai, and then fly over to Hong Kong, do some business there, and then work your way back home. And he told me that, or she told me that, you're flying on Emirates. That would be the good news, because this is an airline I have been dying to fly on. Man, would I love to be on a airline with this kind of comfort. Put your seat in the upright position. Holy moly, look at this. Here's the good news from Emirates. They made an announcement today that if you book a flight and take a flight between now and the end of October, you are going to be covered for your funeral expenses if you happen to catch the virus while on one of these flights. What a move. What they're saying is they're so confident that their planes are spotless and are safe that if you take a flight between now and the end of October and you test positive for the virus and you die, there is an insurance policy built into your airfare that automatically covers the cost of your funeral. Now, talk about peace of mind travel from a world-class carrier. I think it's a great publicity stunt myself. Gets you talking. Certainly made me look at photos of Emirates, looking at these A380s. There's three of them right there. Those three planes right there, $1.2 billion. That's the equivalent of an Oasis-class ship from Royal Caribbean, like the Symphony of the Seas. Boy, what I love to fly this airline. Way to go, Emirates. Anyway, in conclusion, we just are not going to be doing this for a while on board a cruise ship. As much as I would love to be on a Norwegian ship planning a cruise right now and dreaming of getting into a couple of go-karts with my wife and tearing up the track on the top of the cruise ship, it's just not going to happen for a while. The CDC questionnaire just came out the other day. And the kind of questions that they're asking the public to respond to are the kind of questions that tell me there is no way a cruise line can afford to restart right now with all of the restrictions and requirements that the CDC would want to implement on board with these ships, medical wings and extra doctors and a whole bunch of tests. And oh my gosh, I just can't see it happening. So right now we're going to have to look at photos like this and just sigh in frustration and just wish that we were on these ships. Hopefully we'll be able to get on them sooner rather than later, but we'll have to wait for that day to come. Again, thank you everybody for subscribing to my channel, giving my videos thumbs ups. Love getting your comments as always. Please join my Facebook group page, head over to Instagram, check out the Redbubble store down below, and please consider becoming a sponsor member of Traveling with Bruce. And we'll see you Monday nights at 7 o'clock for the sponsor member hangout show and 8 o'clock for the regular show. In the meantime, everybody, have a good day. We'll talk to you later. Bye for now.